Hi everyone! In this video, we'll be discussing what is by far the most talked about subject in my comments section, aeration. So I've got a new cloner here that I'm excited to get set up. Shout out to Skunkbox. This is mostly a reservoir and a lid with holes in it. We've got some neck cups and these neoprene collars, which you may recall from some of my previous content. I've been using these and really enjoying them. Last but not least, we've got an air pump and an air stone. Looks like we get pretty good bubble coverage throughout this reservoir. I don't have too much to say about this, but I'm super intrigued to see if we can clone plants faster than we could without the cloner. So right away as a test run, I chopped down a basil plant and got myself four cuttings to propagate. I'm gonna cut two of these stems with 45 degree angles and the two others with a split technique, which I've demonstrated here before. I'm gonna put these into both still water and the cloner. I've got one 45 degree angle and one split stem in each of these two propagation setups. Now, aeration is 100% not needed to propagate a cutting and get good root growth. I've done this a bunch of times on the channel. I've been able to propagate a variety of plants in stagnant water, and I've had more successes than failures with that method. Now, these basil plants, however, wouldn't perform as I was expecting. I lost the split stem cuttings in both conditions and would eventually lose the 45 degree angle cut in the cloner. I'm taking personal responsibility for these failures, and I think I needed more water in the cloner for it to be successful. So we'll be taking that learning and coming back for a better trial. I've got bell pepper plants here this time that I will be taking cuttings from. I'm setting up three cuttings in small jars and three more in the cloner. Everything has been dipped in Clonex. It's not necessary, but it definitely helps. We'll follow along and see how these two cohorts compare over time. In the early days, our plant's leaves would get pretty limp, which looks bad, but it always seems to turn out fine. By day six, the flowers on my cuttings were getting bigger and some were even blooming. This is going to be a waste of the plant's energy, so I went around and removed all of the flowers I could see from every cutting we have. Still no roots at this point, but our leaves are maintaining their vigor these days, and it seems like they're doing okay in both the cloner and the jars. On day 11, we would see our first signs of a root emerging from a plant that has been in the cloner. It's super tiny, but that root exists. Point one to the cloner for having the first cutting to show a root. Our two other cloner stems don't have roots yet, but do appear to be swelling a bit. This is a sign that roots may be near. Our jar plants, on the other hand, don't look quite as promising. Not the same amount of swelling here, but in general, the leaves look fine. I'm sure these plants are progressing, albeit slower. Checking in on day number 13, our first plant to root was progressing nicely. It looks like we have multiple roots emerging now. Our second cloner plant was beginning to pop as well. We can see some white just starting to come through the bottom of that stem. Cloner plant number three has no roots to show yet. As we look at our aeration free cuttings, we've got no roots, no roots, and maybe some small roots. Looks like one of these cuttings is doing something and trying to sneak into third place ahead of our final cloner plant. It wasn't until 17 days after we took our cuttings that we would see good clear root formation on one of our aeration free plants. Our first plant here has one clear root and maybe a couple more just beginning to emerge. Our second plant appears to be swelling nicely with a bit of white starting to build on the stem. Our third plant looks about the same as the second, probably just about to extend some roots. So this is promising and shows what I mentioned earlier, that we can propagate in still water. It is possible, but let's see how our aerated plants are doing at this point. For our first plant from the cloner here, these roots are considerably longer than the aeration-free counterparts. We've got multiple roots emerging from the stem here, and it looks like more to come in the near future. Our second cloner plant that we will look at, wow, doing even better. We got a ton of roots emerging. Some of them are getting pretty long at this point. Plant looks great. And our last cloner cutting, this one was the first to root and should be doing the best, and it clearly is. These roots are considerably longer than all of the other roots, There seems to be more here than the other plants have as well. Just a great showing for the cloner overall, and we see that these root systems are far and ahead above their aeration-free counterparts. We joined these plants for the last time 24 days after we took the cuttings. We are looking at the jar cuttings here, aeration-free, with pretty small root development, and now getting into the plants which were in the cloner. These roots are incredibly longer than anything on the jar plants. These systems look incredibly healthy, bright white. I'm pretty comfortable saying that the cloner is the winner of this race. Our cloner plants might be 1 to 2 weeks ahead of those in the stagnant water, and that's a lot of time throughout a growing season for that growth to compound. We're going to be looking at bigger, better harvests if we're able to get 2 weeks ahead. Beyond these peppers, I've also been experimenting with some other random plants. You can see some sage here that propagated quite well in the cloner. I'm pretty happy with the effectiveness of the cloner overall. One benefit to the stagnant just jar method is that it's silent, right? The bubbler does make a little bit of noise, but outside of that bit of noise, I'm loving the results that I'm seeing here with the Skunkbox cloner. I'm also trying to clone some trees, and I'll have a video coming on that topic soon. Super excited to see if I can get some trees to propagate within the cloner, so stay tuned for that. Let me know if you like aeration with your cloning or hydroponics in general, which I already know you do. Hit me up with that stuff in the comments. Thanks for watching, and happy harvesting!